Hello and welcome to Club Notes, a monthly TV show of the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. I'm Richard DeGroote, your host for today's show. We're going to be updating some of the programs that have been taking place at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club, as well as talking to one of our partner organizations that's been helping us out a great deal over the years. But before we get started, we'd like to put up our contact information so that if you want to learn more about the Olivet Boys and Girls Club, we have our website that you can visit, www.olivetbgc.org. You can visit us on Facebook, Twitter, and every other one of the social media platforms. Our administrative offices are located at 1161 Pershing Boulevard. If you'd like to give us a call, it's 610-373-1314. We have multiple club locations throughout the city of Reading. The weather's starting to get a little colder, so that's when we usually see a lot more of our members come back. So one thing that the heat will draw them in for the winter activities, and hopefully it won't be as rough a winter as last year. We have a special guest, and I want to give her a preamble before we go to her. This afternoon, my original guest had canceled at the last minute, and I went down to our kitchen to look for something to eat and to complain about how somebody could cancel on me at the last minute. And all of a sudden, I heard a voice coming through the pots and pans of the cooking class preparation, and it was Jodi Readinger from Berks Community Action, who has been helping us out a great deal. Jodi said, "I'll come and do the show." So this is with 2 hours notice. Jodi, thank you.
Who gets
thank
me
you.
Out of doing the dishes?
I know. And what's for dinner tonight?
Chili and rice and cornbread.
That's right. And, I usually try to sample it, but I just thought I wouldn't risk it before the show. So I may stop over afterwards. But Jodi has been coming and doing cooking classes with the club. And in your role at BCAP, talk a little bit about that before we talk about what you've been doing with the clubs.
My role at BCAP, I'm the Community Relations Coordinator, which is a position pretty much unique to BCAP. And what I do is I do outreach into the community. I've been running our youth mini grant for the past several months, doling out money to different youth programs across the county, getting to go on field trips and visit different places. We're just wrapping up a uniform project that we purchased uniforms from Vanity Fair, and we are delivering them to all 13 elementary schools and 4 middle schools in the Reading School District to help with their uniform closets. And kids that come in don't have a uniform. Families, we're seeing some families coming from the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico who are in need of uniforms because their children are new Reading School District.
And how
students.
Many uniforms did you get?
About 3,000 pieces.
3,000. I know she had talked to me about getting a truck, and it just didn't work out. I need a truck, and I felt so bad when I saw it in the paper, but I'm glad that everything went well. We talked about the cooking class. What kind of cooking have you been doing at the Clinton Street Club?
We do a little bit of everything in Clinton Street. I do a lot of baking on my own, so usually there's something sweet involved, but I have been trying since Clinton Street this year is feeding the kids a meal before they go home. I have been trying to make it a little bit more well-balanced. And because it makes it easier on everybody involved, then I bring dinner also on a Wednesday night. So that's taken care of, and we're not tripping over each other prepping the meal in the kitchen. And this week it actually became a family affair. My husband made the chili. So it was simmering in my kitchen overnight, and he doled it into the containers, and I picked it up and brought it over to Clinton Street quick this afternoon.
Well, it's kind of an interesting assembly. You've got some of your BCAPers and then you've got some of the club kids and the club staff all helping out, and they were making some spiders out of pretzels and donuts today.
Right, because Halloween is next week and this is my last cooking club before Halloween. We were making some spiders with Ritz crackers and with donuts. They were doing some witches' hats and some witches' brooms. They made breadsticks with cheese inside to look like bones.
Okay.
So
now we talked about the cooking class, but also I know that we've been doing some basketball and mentoring programs with Stefan and Jermel.
Yes.
Have been coordinating on that. How's that been going?
That has been absolutely incredible. One of my coworkers, our father coordinator, Stefan Faines, who is a Clinton Street Cobra, bleeds green. and got us into doing more with Clinton Street. And Jermel Mitchell, who is the assistant director at Clinton Street, decided they wanted to reach out to some older boys, some teenagers, and help them with some basketball skills, but also some mentoring. Because, you know, when the kids' hands are busy, their mouths go a little bit more often than if you just try to sit down and talk to them. So we were able to, with the mini grants we had this summer, we went over to Dick's Sporting Goods and they schooled me in all this incredible basketball equipment, you know, basketballs that go into Bluetooth and things that show you if your shot's right and all that. But they do an incredible job. It's Thursday nights now. They get about 30 kids a night.
Yeah. I know Mel comes down and he's got this nose cover thing that assists with breathing for playing basketball. I said, it's not that cold in here, but it's some sort of training stuff. And so, but Jermel and Stefan, as Jodi had said, Steph's one of my kids from Clinton Street that grew up to be okay, you know?
He is an incredible young man and a great asset to BCAP. I tell him that all the time, except when he gives me more work, which is usually a lot of times I tell him I'm not going to talk to him because we usually end up figuring out something else we can do.
And you know, this is just a great collaboration that, you know, with BCAP, Deja Harris and your staff and have worked well together. And so it's just how two organizations can better serve the youth of the city of Reading. Now, I know this summer, I don't know where I was. Tell me about this ice cream party that you guys had and how I didn't know about it.
The last day of summer camp. We've been coming in for cooking class and things like that, but I offered to provide an ice cream party for the kids for the last day. Jermel and Walter,
yes,
the custodian, had cooked out. Miss Sue had made macaroni and cheese and rice and beans, and we came in and provided ice cream and toppings for all the kids. And it's a really great visual when we come in from BCAP. Some of my coworkers and I, usually Miss Liz, some others, Kalina and Charette, with our BCAP t-shirts on because they're nice and bright. And it's a chance to reach out and get to meet some kids that we might not otherwise get a chance to meet.
And I know we're going to be working together on the Thanksgiving dinner.
Yes, we are.
And so we're looking forward to that again this year. And I know last year the gym was full. We moved it from the multipurpose room into the gym. It was so full. So we greatly appreciate that. Now, I know it was the beginning of this week, we had a field trip that we took.
Last week, yeah.
To fantasy skating, and if we could talk a little bit about what the kids were doing out at fantasy, and then we'll show some of the pictures.
Fantasy has a program they call it a STEM party, and what they do is the kids get a chance. They have about a 45-minute lesson. They have six or seven topics. What we had chosen was the science and engineering of roller skating and the history of it. So they got a chance to learn, you know, how roller skates were invented, how they work, all kinds of different trajectories and physics and things like that, but it was presented in a fun, engaging way that they almost weren't like learning. And I was pretty impressed because we had kids there from 6 to 13, and it kind of hit with all of them. They were all able to understand and be engaged and be part of the lesson.
And you can't lose a kid wearing a lime green t-shirt.
And we didn't even plan it that way, but what was so cool was when they started to go skating, the lights really picked it up great, and they looked great on the skate rink.
So it was a classroom situation before?
They actually pulled tables out onto the middle of the rink.
Okay.
And we did it in the middle of the rink. And then afterwards, we got to go skating. And they gave the kids a snack, either a slice of pizza or a hot dog or some nachos and a drink, and then they got to go skating for about an hour and a half.
Now, once again, I might have taken the dare to go skating. It's been...
I was not getting myself on skates. I did have my coworker, Miss Liz, she was on skates, and Jermel got on skates, and some of the other staff that went with. The kids had an absolutely fantastic time. I have to give them all credit because the ones that could skate helped the ones that couldn't. It was great cooperation. They behaved themselves so well. The woman who runs Fantasy even commented to me how well-behaved they were and what a joy they were.
Yeah, if you're not familiar with the STEM, it's science, technology, engineering, and math. And it's been determined that these are the skills that our young people will need to go out into the workforce. And, so STEM is the it phrase.
Right.
And sometimes you hear STEAM because they throw art into the equation. But we do appreciate helping to bring our young people out there, paying for a bus for our kids to go out there. And there were 50 kids?
Yep.
50 kids that went out there on a Monday afternoon. So they learned.
They learned something. They had a lot of fun. They cooperated very well together. And it was great pictures. It was a great evening. And I'm glad we're able to do that.
You know, and I was thinking about, you know, the collaborations over the years, and it's been 20-plus years.
25
years. That we've been doing stuff. Back to the our days up at Blue Mountain Camp, but we won't talk about that.
One of my first projects at BCAP was Camp Mio at Blue Mountain Camp.
And our staff is still in therapy over that one. They have a lot of fun. They have a lot of fun. But Jodi, sincerely, I do want to thank you and Steph and all of our BCAP friends. Larry's one of us.
He's a Clinton Street kid also.
Another Clinton Street kid. You can't go around the city of Reading without running into a bunch of old Olivet kids. But we're greatly happy with our relationship with BCAP. And we'll talk a little bit more at the end. And I'm going to show you some pictures of kids that you may know.
Okay.
One of the things that we've been doing with Myrna Fuchs, we've been doing the College Access program, and I'd like to show some of the pictures from our College Access. So if we could go to our first one. And okay, there's our, okay. I don't know where our picture isn't showing, but we have some pictures from our college fair where we had a number of colleges that came to our Mulberry Street Club, and this is where the College Access program is worked out of mostly. We get a great deal of our seniors from Reading High that come down through the Mulberry Street Club, and hopefully we'll be able to get the pictures up from the computer. And we have some pictures of young people that were accepted on site at Kutztown that night. And fortunately, some of them received some substantial scholarships.
That's fantastic.
So we're really, really happy with what Myrna and they've been doing with the College Access program. And hopefully we'll get this working in a minute. And we can show you the pictures of what's going on.
So what do they do in the College Access program?
Well, they learn about financial aid. They learn about essays that they need to write. They do SAT prep. So we had about 12 different colleges that came and had tables for our young people that night that they could actually learn more about the colleges. And okay, I'm just finding out that the pictures are blocked. So I don't know why. So we're running into some technical difficulties, and we'll talk a little bit more about that. But we did have a tour this week. We went down to Westchester, and we were able to visit with Elise Jackson, somebody that you've known. We were at the University of Penn about a week ago, and it was the top five students in the Reading High class were on that tour, and it was really very impressive that the top five students in the Reading High class were on this tour of the University of Pennsylvania. We've been up at Kutztown, and the kids had a great time up there. Moving along, if you'd see the pictures, the kids are all happy.
Well, that's a scholarship would make anybody happy.
I know.
Parents were even happier.
I know. We do want to mention that we did get our next class of AmeriCorps students. We have about 25 to 30 AmeriCorps students who are working at the club. They're working with Kat Royer, and they're doing service projects at the club. They're assisting the club staff, and it's a great opportunity for our young people to get employment as well as to learn about youth service. So these are high school through college age students that are working with the AmeriCorps program. They get a small stipend, and it's more than a small stipend, but they do get a stipend working with the program, but they're also getting valuable experience of working with social service agencies and youth service agencies. So we want to say, if you are a young person in high school and through college, and if you're interested in the AmeriCorps program, give us a call, 610-373-1314. Ask for Kat Royer. Kat is our AmeriCorps volunteer coordinator. So,
and the kids at the club get so much out of it too, because they get to see somebody that's in high school that was right where they were a couple of years ago, or college.
Yeah, these are a great deal of them are former club kids.
Yeah.
We've got Raul is working over at Clinton Street. I think of him as a former Youth of the Year. So it's just a great opportunity to work your way up the chain.
And give back a little.
Yeah. And, possibly get some sort of a educational benefit that may help you into a career. So it's the AmeriCorps program. And give us a call, 610-373-1314. And we're working feverishly on getting these pictures together. Originally on the show tonight, we were going to be talking about our Mulberry Street Club. So you see a little bit of our Mulberry Street Club on the banner. So we do have some pictures of our Mulberry Street Club that we wanted to share with you. The Mulberry Street Club, Jodi, has been around since 1914.
Wow.
It's over 100 years old that we've been working out of the same building with the two additions on it. So we're very, very proud of our Mulberry Street Club. It's actually three buildings tied in together. And I've been doing the research with Boys and Girls Clubs, and we believe that we are the oldest singly used building in the country. So.
Oh, that's cool. Cool.
And the unique thing is that the Olivet organization, we will be celebrating our 120th anniversary next year. So
wow.
Maybe we can do a special dinner over at Clinton Street. We'll do the chili and things like that. But we are asking that if you are any former club alumni, you know, we've talked about some of our alumni now. We're looking to reconnect with you and have the opportunity to form somewhat of an alumni association. So once again, if you are a former club kid, you can give us a call at 610-373-1314. I'm not sure if the pictures are up yet, but we're going to keep going and plodding through. And at the end of the show, we'll do a quick run through of all the pictures that we are so eloquently talking about now.
That's, I didn't realize Mulberry Street was that old. That's incredible.
Yeah. It's, you know, it was an old silent movie theater when it first started, and it was just, it's been in the Olivet organization since 1914.
I thought Clinton Street was old.
Well, Clinton Street, the property, we've been on that property since 1910. The original club was in the parking lot, and then the new club was built in the mid-70s. So it's kind of the same footprint, different, newer building on that. One other thing that we did today is we had a group from Lowe's that came by and are doing a community service project at our Oak Brook Club. We have I'm told that our pitchers are up. I'm not sure how I get to them. Okay, we'll keep moving along, and they're not on the screen. Over at the Lowe's group rebuilt our front steps at the Oak Brook Club. Here we go.
Here we go? Okay.
We'll talk a little bit about this. This is our college access that hopefully we can show the pictures now.
Yes,
this is one of our young ladies that she got a full scholarship to Kutztown, and she has the It's Good to Be Golden. Here's another one of our young ladies that got a scholarship through the College Access Program, and she's going to be going to Kutztown. This is on the University of Pennsylvania campus. This was a young man. He's from Hawaii, but he's originally from Australia.
Wow.
And so it was just a very interesting accent that he was talking to, because he gave a heck of a tour on the Penn campus. Every time we go and we have lunch at the campus, and one of the young ladies in the picture is currently attending Penn. She's from Reading High, and she talks to the students about really what they need to look for in selecting a college. And in that picture is Myrna. This is Elise. This was at Westchester, which we were just at this past Monday. We always end up at the dining hall.
Oh,
and part of my job is to rate the food, so Westchester did fairly well with the food. This is our AmeriCorps group. Kat and is on the far side in the green. She does a heck of a job recruiting our, and then you can see Raul in the middle of it, but our AmeriCorps students that are serving the club. Okay, this is some pictures of the original Mulberry Street Club. This is now what is the games room. This is upstairs. This is the computer center now. It used to be a games room. This is the third floor, which we don't have access to anymore, but that was a what was a teen lounge. And then this was the original exterior of the Mulberry Street Club at 722. You can see there was a printing business next to it that's no longer there. And this is the current exterior. Now we're moving along fairly quickly. We've got about 3 minutes. This is our group from Lowe's, the Lowe's Heroes, that's doing the front steps over at Oakbrook. They're doing a tremendous job over there. They're getting ready to tear out the former steps, and I'm looking forward to driving by to see how much they've done today. They ripped out the railroad ties, and they're putting in all new bedding, and
Somebody posted it on Facebook. I saw it this afternoon.
Very good. Then this is the main walkway. It splits into two parts, and then we're back to our college access. So that's our quick tour. So I apologize for... We were setting up, and I think we had another program that was starting to come on the computer, so we had a little bit of a glitch, but we got through it. But I do want to thank all of the students that are going on our college access programs. We've got some, we were at Alvernia the other day. We're going out to Penn State Berks. We're going to be up here at Albright. And going back to Franklin and Marshall, that's a beautiful campus down there. And it's just a great program that Myrna and the Olivet Boys and Girls Club working together, getting our young people into college. But once again, I do want to talk a little bit about, if you are an alumni of the club, give us a call, 373-1314. We're going to be starting some alumni activities so that we'll be able to start getting alumni associations that can come out and support the club, whether it's through time, talent, or resources. We're just there's the Larry Barringers and the Stephen Fains and all of the other young guys that are out there and doing well in the community and supporting our community. But we do want to thank Joanne Fabrics. We had a great donation for Halloween. You've seen a lot of them through the Clinton Street Club. All of our clubs have been decorated.
The tutus.
Yes. They are incredible, but we do want to thank Jodi for pinch hitting, and she even helped out in the pinch with the when we were having the technical difficulties. So thank you, Jodi, for all that you do and all that BCAP does for the community. Hopefully, if they're watching at Clinton Street, save me some chili so we get back. If you are looking for some activities, our basketball programs are going to be starting in November. Our football programs are wrapping up. We have recreation, education, and guidance programs for boys and girls ages 6 to 18. So give us a call. For Jodi and myself, thank you very much. We'll see you next month.
Thank you.